Good day. The state television company of Western Armenia represents all the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. The ecosystem of Lake Van is on the verge of extinction. Russian peacekeepers ensured safe work in the Republic of Artsakh. Pashinyan and Aliyev confirmed the agreement on the opening of the railway. The Republic of Armenia will get access to Iran and Russia. The problems of Shushi residents should be solved as soon as possible, Ashut Harutyunyan. An Armenian church was destroyed in Western Armenia this year. The Armenian cemetery of Van was completely destroyed. The International Commission of Religious Freedom of the USA. Treasure hunters destroyed the Armenian church of St. Stephanos in Van. America has decided to build roads in Armenia and Georgia at its own expense. The International Conference Medzamor Reading II will start in Medzamor Museum Reserve. The largest lake in Western Armenia, Lake Van, continues to dry up due to the drought, which is unprecedented compared to recent years. Compared to previous years, along with precipitation and decrease in temperature and an increase in evaporation, there is a serious decrease in the water level in Lake Van, exceeding 2 kilometers. Professor of the Geography Department of the Literary Faculty of the Sentinel University of Van, Dr. Faruk Alea Dinoglu, said the following about Lake Van. The drying of the lake will also affect tarek, which is an endemic species of fish. If this continues, it will lead to the disappearance of the entire number of fish in the rivers. As we see, the places that were once called bird paradises have dried up. This situation will lead to disappearance of the living population. This will affect the entire ecosystem. If water consumption is not managed, there may be a shortage of drinking water in the pool. The servicemen of the Russian peacekeeping contingent ensured the safe sowing of various agricultural crops near the demarcation line in the village of Majkalashen in the Martyri region of Artsakh. This is reported by the press service of the Minister of Defense of the Russian Federation. During the week, with the support of the military personnel of the Russian peacekeeping contingent, workers on a territory of more than 40 hectares sowed seed on various lands. Taking into account the fact that agricultural lands are located near the demarcation line, the district administration asked the command of the Russian peacekeeping contingent to ensure the safety of the work. At the moment, 40 hectares of territory have already been cultivated, said Sergei Gapeyev, a representative of Russian peacekeeping contingent. At the trilateral meeting of Armenian Prime Minister Nikol Pashinyan, European Council President Charles Michel, and Azerbaijani President Ilham Aliyev, an agreement on restarting the railway was confirmed. This was announced by the Prime Minister Pashinyan after the meeting in Brussels. At a trilateral meeting with EU Council President Charles Michel and Azerbaijani President Ilham Aliyev, we confirmed the agreement on the opening of the railway. Accordingly, the railway will operate in accordance with internationally recognized border and custom rules on a principle of reciprocity under the sovereignty and jurisdiction of the countries. Armenia will have access by railway to the Islamic Republic of Iran and the Russian Federation. We also agreed to continue contacts, Pashinyan said. President Armenak Abramyan's reaction was instant, he wrote. At a trilateral meeting, to confirm the agreement on restarting the railway means that Armenia will enter Iran and Russia through Nakhichevan. In accordance with this statement, the railway will operate with international accepted rules at a border and customs on a principle of reciprocity under the sovereignty and jurisdiction of the countries. After the Artsakh war, Nakhichevan would have become de jure, that is no longer de facto, official and illegal part of Azerbaijan for the Republic of Armenia. As already noted, the government of Western Armenia rejects any agreement that promotes further division of this territory. During a meeting with residents of Shushi in the Yerevan office of Western Armenia, the director of Museum of the History of the City, historian Ashot Harutyunyan, addressed the government of Western Armenia, noting, due to the occupation of the city of Shushi and other districts of Republic of Artsakh by Turkish-Azerbaijani troops and international terrorists and the threat of the lives to the population, hundreds of families have found refuge in the Republic of Armenia. Therefore, in order to solve social and legal problems, we ask you to assist citizens and grant refugee status. Then he touched upon the last Artsakh war and its consequences as well as on the cases of the capture of Shushi before this war, drawing attention to such important details that were decisive during this war. In the statement on Turkey on December the 3rd, the Commission stressed, this year an Armenian church was destroyed in Western Armenia. The Armenian cemetery of Van was completely destroyed too. These are forms of intimidation when important places of religious and cultural importance are destroyed. According to Tony Perkins, religious minorities in Turkey, including followers of the Armenian Apostolic Church, are increasingly restricted by their rights. In its report, the International Commission on Religious Freedom of the United States recommends that the State Department include Turkey in a special list, as the authorities of this country tolerate gross violations of the rights of the religious minorities. Treasure hunters destroyed the historical Armenian church of St. Stepanos in Muradiye region in western Armenia, at the foot of Mount Aksorik. The church of St. Stepanos, which was an extremely important holy place for Armenians, was built in 17th century and operated until 1915, the genocide of Armenian people. Currently, the church, which has been constantly destroyed over the past 15 years, is under threat of destruction. The Argumenti.ru newspaper stated that the United States intends to spend money on improving the transport and road network in the Caucasus. This specifically concerns Georgia and Armenia. The cost of the program for the improvement of the proposed highway is currently estimated at $45 million. This is dedicated by military necessity. It seems that these states have decided to create a serious threat to Russia in the Caucasus strategic direction. As the newspaper notes, in the case of Armenia, it is worth thinking very seriously. This country is a member of SCTO, that is, it is military ally of Russia, and there is a Russian military base on its territory. The US decision to invest in a country's road system indicates that Washington expects to make this country as loyal a partner as Georgia is now. There is simply no other option. The Metsamor Museum Reserve will host the international conference Metsamor Readings II, which is attended by the historians and archaeologists from Poland, Austria, Georgia, Russia and Kazakhstan. Addressing the issues discussed on a conference, Doctor of Historical Science Professor Ashot Piliposyan noted, Metsamor is an ancient settlement of Bronze Iron period, a settlement and a mausoleum, and it is so important that a whole culture of the Bronze Age Early Iron is called Lejashen Metsamorian. Of course, most of the reports are devoted especially to the great excavation on 2017-2021, the work of the Armenian-Polish International Archaeological Expedition. But in addition, we have many reports that will make the conference more generalized. He also said that the conference will include a demonstration of unique samples of gold objects, which present gold objects or other valuable objects discovered during excavation from the 1980s to 2021. Now the musical part, Armenian folk song Sasun. The full version of this video is available on Western Armenia's YouTube channel. This was all for today. Goodbye.